Our guest and eminent speaker, Honorable Dr. A.M. Nawle sir, has joined. So I request Professor S.C. Mamane, Head of Electrical Engineering Department, to please give brief introduction of the third session speaker and guest, Honorable Dr. Arvind Nawle sir. Mamane sir.
Hello, I am audible?
Yes sir, you are audible.
Thank you ma'am. Good afternoon to one and all. I am Mamane Sanjeev, Head Electrical Engineering Department. It's my immense pleasure to introduce today's eminent speaker, Dr. Arvind Nawle sir. Sir has completed MA, BEd and PhD in English. Sir has more than 19 years of teaching experience at senior college level. He has more than 20 years of administrative experience. Sir is working as a coordinator and member of NAC steering committee. He has worked as a member of the Senate at SRTM University, Nanded. He has worked as a member of Board of Studies in English at SRTM University, Nanded. He has worked as a member of Research Allocation Committee at SRTM University, Nanded. He has worked as a member panel of External Examiner, PhD coursework, Youth Festival, Student Welfare Department at Solapur University, Solapur. Also, he has working as a member, editorial, advisory and review board of 15 prestigious international journals. Sir has published more than 37 books, and out of which 25 books are subscribed by the world's 142 renowned overseas libraries, including USA, UK, South Africa, Australia, Germany, Canada, and so on. He has presented more than 22 research papers in international, national level seminars and conferences. Sir has delivered more than 29 talks as a guest research person and chairperson in international, national level seminars, workshop and conferences. He has also recognized as a PhD teacher and PhD research supervisor. Six students has completed their PhD under the guidance of Nawle sir. He has completed one UGC minor research project in English. So I heartily welcome you sir on behalf of VPIT. Thank you sir. Over to you Kulkarni ma'am.
On behalf of VPIT, we welcome you, Honorable Dr. Arvind Nawle sir. So without taking much time, I request Dr. A.M. Nawle sir to start with the third session on the topic, Student Satisfaction Survey.
Thank you, ma'am. Am I audible clearly and visible clearly?
Yes. Yes, sir.
Okay. If any technical disturbance you found, let me.
Okay, sir.
Okay. The authorities of VVPIET Solapur, the management president, Honorable Dr. G.K. Deshmukh ji, Honorable Secretary, Amul Nana Chauhan ji, Vice Principal, Dr. Umesh Mughle ji, the inaugural guest and speaker, Honorable Dr. Dina Ghane, Deputy Advisor of NAC Bangalore, and the next speaker who talked just earlier to me, Honorable Captain Principal Dr. Itinji Sonze, Professor Rawat, IQC Coordinator, and rest members of Organizing Committee of one day national webinar on NAC accreditation and assessment process organized by VVP Institute of Engineering and Technology Solapur in association with NAC Bangalore and esteemed participants. Good afternoon to one and all. In both sessions, Honorable Dr. Lina Ghane and Principal Captain Dr. Nitinji Sonze talked on overall accreditation and assessment process, revised the accreditation framework, and both have covered all seven criterions and clearly explained almost all points right from the beginning of a process to the peer team visit. And now it's my turn, and the topic assigned to me for this session is Student Satisfaction Survey, which is popularly known with its acronyms as AAAS. And I'm supposed to cover the procedure of conducting AAAS, which forms component 2.7, one of the very complicated, vexed, yet very important part, not only of criterion 2, but also of NAAQS whole assessment and accreditation process. Friends, though our entire education system focuses on its most important stakeholder, that is the student, until then there had been no provision or appropriate and systematic framework for the assessment of teachers and the functioning of the digital institutions and its services, its teaching and quality of education by students. In India, there are about 833 universities plus 42,000 colleges and 35.7 million students so far, and there is a need to get real feedback from the students' community to enhance the quality of higher education. Student satisfaction should be an integral component of management process in addition to academic standards, accreditation, teaching and research. AAAS thus tells us about the opinions of the students about the efficiency of various facilities like library and so on, and other student related services available in the college. In fact, in AAAS, there is no question out of 21, the 20 are the MCQ like choice based questions. It has options, and last one is a open end question. 20 first question is, and there is no emphasis given on the other facilities, but directly it get covered there. The more emphasis is on teaching learning. Therefore, such survey gives an outline about how things should be planned to ensure better services and facilities to students, better teaching learning atmosphere, because the students are the foremost stakeholders of our institutions. Since its establishment in 1994, NAAQS has been actively working to advance our country's higher education. A major goal of education by colleges and universities has been considered to be sustaining and enhancing the satisfaction of students. In the revised AA framework introduced in July 2017, NAAQS introduced this AAAS, that is a student satisfaction survey, which characterizes an evident paradigm shift in the higher education institute's AA process. The revised assessment and accreditation framework introduced many welcoming changes. The new AA process is streamlined, and the number of questions, the size of report, and the days of the visits are decreased by implementing the peer team pre-visit pre-qualifier, by introducing the SGS, system-generated scores, with the fix of 70% online assessment and 30% peer judgment, by introducing third-party data validation, which is called the DVV, on which ma'am very wonderfully talked up, by introducing suitable differences in metrics, weight, and benchmarks to universities, autonomous and affiliated and constituted colleges, and above all, by introducing the more active participation of students in AA process to AAAS. The NAAQ made the AA process more robust, objective, transparent, outcome-oriented, and stakeholder-friendly. Students' level of commitment is determined by the kind of experiences they encounter, the magnitude of the feeling of comfort, and the intellectual stimulus generated by learning situations. Their inputs submit substantially reflect the actual quality of teaching learning process, enabling identifications of the strengths of teaching as well as the possible improvements therein. Student satisfaction thus is a direct indicator of the effectiveness of teaching learning process in the institutions of higher education. This is the reason what I think so. The revised assessment framework of NAAC has introduced the AAAS. AAAS is conducted on two levels. First, AAAS as a regular annual survey by IQC at institutional level. And second, AAAS being conducted by NAAC authorities as part of a process before their on-ground visit. In AAAS of the first case, that is a regular annual survey by IQC at the institutional level, students are asked to assess their educational experiences in colleges. They are given questionnaire which ask for their feedback on their overall classroom experience, co-curricular activities, and the campus. The questionnaire forms are handed over to them in confidentially, wherein they express their opinions. The responses of the students and the rest concerned are informed about analysis made by the students and changes if necessary to be made therein. In the second type, that is at the NAAC levels, AAAS, NAAC authorities conducts this student satisfaction survey as part of a process before their on-site visit. The student's satisfaction survey is an efficient feedback mechanism and is an attempt to promote the quality assurance process to involve students who are our prime stakeholders. The SSR for UG and PG affiliated or constituent colleges has a total 93 and 96 metrics as talked by Captain Dr. Sanjayji. With the help of the student satisfaction survey, your SSR will be validated. The AAAS is being carried out at the same time as the DVV. The score obtained in the AAAS will be part of the overall CGPA. That's what is very important. The assessment process will be carried out in three stages. It will comprise three main components, namely SSR, that is self-study report, SSES and PTR, peer team report. The SSR has a total of 115 metrics for university, 107 metrics for autonomous institution, and 93 and 96 metrics for UG and PG affiliated or the constituent colleges respectively. Submission of IIQA, that is Institutional Information for Quality Evaluation, more or less similar to the old LOI, letter of intent of the previous process, will be the first step. At the next step, when the IIQA is accepted, institution can send their SSR online in the formats given in the SSR manuals available on the NAAC website. At the next point, the data or the information provided in the SSR will be validated by a third party DVV, which is called the data validation and verification process, via an online evaluation mechanism process, producing a pre-qualifier score. For the next level of online evaluation and accreditation, organizations securing 30% of the qualitative metrics would qualify for on-site peer review. The pre-qualifier score are exclusive of the student satisfaction survey. Higher education institutes are supposed to send the information of all or 50% of this, or 50 to 60% of the enrolled students with their enrollment number, program, year of study, that is the first year, second year, year, email IDs and mobile numbers to NAAC office for conducting triple S in their at their end. NAC will randomly select students for the survey to be responded on the questionnaire. Responses from 10% of the enrolled students qualifies for scoring on the metric. We should therefore be very vigilant about this essential component, which is the procedural detail likely issues to be faced in solutions and proper documentation need to be understood. We will see all these things in my PPT that I am going to present now. I'm sharing it. Is it visible, sir, there? Sir, is my PPT visible?
Yes, sir, it is visible.
And it is visible on the full screen. It is not being seen here. Is it okay? Okay, sir. Is it okay? May I proceed with my PPT?
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. Window is troubling me. Right. Triple S. How Triple S can serve to improve the quality of higher education? First, we will see this. It helps to create a learner-centered environment, obviously, as we are giving a opportunity to the students to share their feedbacks. It will create a learning friendly environment in the institution. The feedbacks we issue to SSS will provide us the data to understand the requirement from the student's side, right? We will come to know through this about the opinions of the students on the efficiency of teaching learning and some correlated facilities like internet, ICT facilities, and so on. It provides an auditable evidences that students have had the opportunity to pass comments on their programs and courses and its delivery. It allows the institution to benchmark and to provide indicators that will contribute to the reputation of the institution in the society. Through this process, student will give us their feedbacks on the academic experiences, strengths and weaknesses of our teaching learning process. And it will help us to understand the level of student satisfaction through experience they undergo or their comforts, feeling of comfort. You may be familiar with the cervical model, which is acceptable globally, like that cervical model of the service quality model, method to capture and measure the service quality experienced by customers, AAAS will help to understand and measure the actual quality of teaching learning process and take measures to improve it. Next slide. This is that you know very well. These are the distribution of weightages for SSR and both ma'am, deputy advisor of NAC, and honorable Captain Sonja sir covered these things. I would like to skip it, that you know very well that the key indicators of this criterion 2, the only I would like to highlight that 2.7, this is called triple here, and for UG colleges it has 60 percentage. Process of very complicated process. We should all, the IQC coordinator, the principal, and all the members should be very vigilant regarding it. It is a process that from the manual I took this as it is without any change. The survey analysis course will be used as the key component of accreditation. A predetermined weightage is also assigned to the key indicators in this accreditation framework. A stratified random sample of the students will be chosen for the survey. Response rate below 10% will not be considered. In sample, students would be spread evenly across different classes, year of enrollment and gender. The higher education students are required to submit the data of all students. It should be submitted in the template provided by the NAC with the details, the class, why is the name, email, mobile number, and so on. The institution or the IQC or the teachers should not by any way try to influence students with respect to the survey. This will ensure genuine feedbacks for the institute to further improvement. There are 21 questions, out of which 20 are MCQ type questions, while one open-ended question, 21st question, already I told you it. 20 MCQ type questions are responded on the scale of 4 to 0 with the most positive response rated as 4 and the most negative response rated as 0. In open-ended questions, student has to give 3 observations or suggestions or expectation to improve the overall teaching learning experience of the institution. In AAAS, questions are asked about specific teaching skills of the teacher, academic environment, opportunity for growth of the students, their motivation, in-person relationship, facilities like internet, ICT, and so on. Questionnaires will be emailed to student by NAC directly on their email IDs and not on college IDs. Responses less than 10% of the total student strength are not considered for evaluation. Questionnaire will be in English and probably may be translated into local language of that institutions. It's probably it may be in bilingual as most of the students have problem with the language. The students across different classes, year of enrollment, programs, genders will be covered randomly by them. And it will be conducted simultaneously with DVV process. We need to upload data of all or at least 50% of currently enrolled students as per data template provided on the portal for colleges, UGRPC and autonomous. Responses should be received from at least 10% of total students or 100, whichever is lesser. Means minimum 100 students responses are required there. And if the larger institute, 10% of enrolled strength. For example, for university, 10% of the total students or minimum 500, whichever is lesser. Probably, SSS will be completed within 1 month after its initiation. Data requirement, this is the data template. Given the manual. What we are supposed to do here? Upload. We are supposed to upload the data of all currently enrolled students or at least 50% as per the data template provided by NAC in Excel sheet only. Only that data would be accepted. Column names, we are not permitted to alter it. No column or cell should be left blank. Repetition of name, emails, mobile number should be avoided. It is not permitted. There are two separate columns for student ID and enrollment ID. In the absence of separate IDs, you can repeat the same ID in the two columns. Total entry should not be greater than the students marked in, mentioned in IIQA report. And this will be administered institutions with quality of peer team visit, that is after hearing the pre-qualifier stage. Analysis. Two types of questions are there. 20 questions are like objective questions with three options, four options, and last one is an open-ended question. The 20 objective type questions, for it, the students are supposed to respond on the scale 4 to 0 as per their choices. The most positive response is scored at 4 and the most negative at 0. The analysis of open-ended question is very important. We should have to orient, provide orientation to student not to expect much than the capacities or not to suggest that which are not practical theory. Students are asked to share their three suggestions or the observations for the improvement of teaching learning experience in the institutions. Its analysis would be carried out by aggregating the most occurring suggestions in the student responses. This should provide the idea of the most general expectations, observation, and suggestions from the students. This information can be provided to peer team conducting on-site visit to be used for the validation as well as peer team report preparation. So it is very important. Teacher skills, that is subject knowledge, communication skills, class preparation, internal evaluation process, use of ICT tools are of most important, because all questions, most of the questions are covered there on this topic. Analysis of questionnaire is carried out by aggregating the most correct occurring suggestions in response. The mean score for each question is calculated and the overall mean is computed. Output of SSS is provided to NAC peer team, and the NAC peer team uses it for validation as well as for evaluation report. This is what the template. Initially, guidelines are given to students, and it is asked first whether they are feeling it a first time or not. One student is supposed to feel it at only one survey, that's why he is supposed to answer the yes. Then age, the college number, gender, male or female, or transgender, the program, that is bachelor's degree, master's degrees, or other anything. Then the subjects you are currently studying, that details you are supposed to give, the students are supposed to give. Student is supposed to reply to all the 21 questions. And in the last question, students has an opportunity to give its suggestions. First question is this: what much of the syllabus was covered in the class? If student opts 85% to 100%, the score of 4 will be allocated. If the student opts below 30, 0 score will be allotted. Please look this, the same type of questions. How well did the teacher prepare for the classes? Thoroughly, satisfactorily, poor, indifferently, and won't teach at all. Sorry, I mentioned you 4 options. No, there are 5 options. How well were the teachers able to communicate? Always effective, sometime effective, just satisfactorily, generally ineffective, or very poor communication. These are the options. The teacher's approach to teaching can best be described as, again, there are choices like excellent, from excellent to the poor. In the 5th question, fairness of the internal evaluation process is asked, with the options always, usually, sometime, unusually, fair or unfair. What was the performance in assessment? Was your performance of assessment discussed with you? This is the question. From every time to never, these are the options. The institutes takes active interest in promoting internship, students exchange, field visit, opportunities for students. It relates to the co-curricular activities also. Randomly to never, these are the options. The teaching and mentoring process in your institute facilitates you in cognitive, social, and emotional growth, from significantly through moderately to never at all, these are the options. The 9th question, the institution provides multiple opportunities to learn and grow. strongly agree, agree, neutral, disagree, and strongly disagree. These are the options. Teachers inform you about your expected competencies, course outcome, and the program outcome. From every time to occasionally to never, these are the options. Your mentor does a necessary follow-up with an assigned task to you from every time to rarely, or I don't have a mentor, these are the options. The teacher illustrate the concept through example and application. Such a micro question too is asked here. These questions are common for the all institutions. I have taken it from manual, it's manual. Time to never is the options. The teachers identify your strength and encourages you with providing right level of challenges. Fully, reasonably, partially, slightly, and not at all. You're unable to, these are the options. Teachers are able to identify your weaknesses and help you to overcome them. Every time, usually, occasionally, sometimes, rarely, never, these are the options. The institution makes effort to engage students in the monitoring, reviews, and continuous quality improvement of the teacher learning process. Strongly agree, agree, neutral, disagree, strongly disagree, these are the options. The institute teachers use student-centric methods such as experimental learning, participatory learning, and problem-solving methodologies for enhancing learning experiences. To a great extent, moderate, somewhat, very little, and not at all, these are the options. Teachers encourage you to participate in extracurricular activities. Strongly agree to strongly disagree. These are the options. Here, the extracurricular activities are covered in one of the last questions. The co-curricular activities are covered. 18 questions. Efforts are made by the institution teachers to inculcate soft skills, life skills, and employability skills to make you ready for the world of work. To a great extent, moderate, somewhat, very little, not at all. The options. 19th question. What percent of teachers uses ICT tools such as LCD projector, multimedia, etc. while teaching? About 90% to below 29%. These are the options. For below 29%, there is a zero score. Second last question, that's the 20th question. The overall quality of teaching learning process in your institute is very good. Strongly agree, agree, neutral, disagree, strongly agree, this option. And most complicated is the last question. This is open-end question. Here, students are supposed to write something, type something there. Give three observations or suggestions to improve the overall teaching learning experience in your institution. Here, this process, you are supposed to provide orientation to students, not to express impractical or exaggerated suggestions or observations here. Otherwise, it will create problem. Now, problems in conducting TSS. TSS has been least practiced in the education sector of India. Newly introduced them. There is a big question on the validity of TSS due to decreasing student attendance in the classroom, then computer illiteracy in the rural areas Majority of the students are unaware of ICT in rural areas, even though they use mobile phone, normal mobile phone, they don't have email IDs. It is a problem. Casual approach of the students in filling questionnaires. Unrealistic, impractical expectation of students in open-end question. This is also a problem. Poor internet facility in rural areas. They are supposed to check the mail with regular intervals. They should have to respond to that mails from the NAC team. Parents of the rural area are not willing to provide phone numbers and email IDs of their wards, especially of girls. It is also a problem. Then what are the solutions? For this, students should be accustomed to this process, conducting PPLS every year in line of NAC model with this questionnaire, 21 questionnaire, by IQC and keeping its record is must. Efforts should be made by institute to increase the involvement of the students in curricular and extracurricular activities. Serious efforts should be made to increase the attendance in the class. IQC of the college should conduct all the primary data that is required at the time of PPLS, at the time of the admission process, and include required things in admission form itself. NAC's poster of SSR should be uploaded on website as well as should display on notice board some prints of the same. And students should be provided with orientation how to fill it, how to respond it. Or the 20 question plus the last one, the open-end question. So that they should be made aware of the realities in education so that their expectation will not be impractical. What are, for example, I would like to show that for every year, whatever the feedback students used to give, you have to prepare a documentation that what you have done on their feedbacks. For example, students asked us most of to regularize the remedial classes, we are regularized. In opening question, they wrote to start the special lecture series. We have started initiative, have been taken and started lecture series, student seminar, or the students have given feedback to increase the ICT halls. We had made augmentation in that ICT halls, etc., and so on. Department, library. This is what the PPLS analysis we have done. You know, it is of 1989. Okay. When I was IQC coordinator, that time we used the tech. Our own template, and this is what the analysis we have made on basics of the students' feedbacks. And I would like to show a model video of very small 1 minutes. You will come to know. You can take by this that. This is the sample. Thank you. Okay, it is one of the example. This is very important. NAC has prepared a poster, and it is available on NAC website. And it is very important to make students aware about it. You are supposed to take printout, color printout of this poster in a bigger size and display on your notice board, different notice boards of science wing or arts wing or in different wings, okay, or the ladies' rooms, all that things. Here, the appealer, NAC itself has prepared it to rate your institute, suggest improvement. And identity will not be disclosed. Means students' email, which student with which email ID has wrote that we want ICT classes. This will not be disclosed. These are the things NAC has appealed. And such the you, it should be on your website also. Look, some of the Netaji Subhash Open University on their website. You will see it. This poster is also. I would like to show one more. It is the IGNU, New Delhi, for the awareness of the triple SMS student. They have made this message. Look here.
We are students of IGNU. Greetings from IGNU. Hope you are healthy and safe. A survey is being conducted by the National Assessment or Accreditation Council, NAAC, which is the apex body for accreditation of all universities. Your participation in the Student Satisfaction Survey, SSS, is absolutely essential as this is an important parameter for accreditation of IGNU. As a bona fide student of this university, IGNU US accreditation by NAAC will be of immense value to you in all your future endeavors. As a rule, with good accreditation, grade points will be recognized by all employers and other stakeholders. SSS is being conducted directly by NAAC. NAAC is sending the survey questionnaire to the IGNU learners on their emails. You are requested to check your mailbox for any communication received from NAAC pertaining to the survey and to respond to it within 2 days and positively before the 31st of July 2020, as the NAAC portal will close on the 31st of July 2020. The SSS consists of only 20 MCQs in which you simply have to select it.
I like it, very light, very innovative, wonderful it is. You are supposed to prepare such audio or video and circulate among your WhatsApp group of students or their emails. This is also one of the way to make students aware. Then you must remember that your principal, sir, must receive this letter. This is an appeal to all vice chancellors and principals from the NAC for the overall awareness of the TSS. And I'm thankful for, let me close my, giving the opportunity to conduct this session. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir.
1 minute, let me stop the sharing. Yes. Yeah, ma'am, and my topic is the open for discussion.
Thank you so much, sir, for your valuable guidance.
Thank you
so much. On behalf of PPIT family, we are very much thankful.
Happy to interact with you.
Yes, sir. Anybody. Yes. Participants are requested to please write your queries in the chat box, or you can raise your
hands. Instead of writing, just face to face. Get them talk.
Yes, sir. Yes. If any participant have any question, any doubt regarding the SSS process or NAC process, they can ask their queries. Host, please check whether the participant has raised the hand for unmuting. Yes.
Yeah, ma'am, there is one doubt. Hello.
Please, proceed.
Yes.
Yeah,
Kavita, ma'am is saying that all the questions in SSS questionnaire are asked. in student satisfaction survey are being asked in feedback system?
Okay, sir, most of the questions are asked in what is the question there? There are 21 minute. Most of the questions are asked in the students in this event. Just obvious, most of the things are covered there in all 20 questions, and one open-ended question is given for you to express yourself. Is hard copy of SSR from students? SSR. Is no, it is not essential. Student, there are minimum 5 to 6 copy the institution or your IQC limit. But you can read your SSR from your institutional website, the soft copy of it. Hard copy is not essential, not required to give the students.
Sir,
is asking for SSS is essential. Hard copy of SSS from the student is essential.
SSR means self-study report. Nothing to do.
Yes.
People, yes. Okay.
Yes. People, yes. The participant is asking about SSS.
No. What I think that, as I have shown one video of the template, the NAC will develop such a template, and you are supposed to click on the link provided in your email, which will be operational from your mobile, Android, as well as from your laptop or computer. And there you are supposed to tick mark the MCQs, and there would be space for 3 suggestions, and you are supposed to type. Yeah.
Hello, good afternoon, sir.
Yes, good afternoon, please.
Hello. So there is one doubt that if a student receives an email, this by NAC, then in how many days he can respond to?
The minimum for this one month the process it takes approximately, but whenever we know that what time they are sending the questionnaire, that time we will means to, it is the duty of all the teachers and the IPC committee to remind the students to periodically check emails.
Yes. Okay. Yes, sir. Yes, and sir.
The deadline will be given there that you are supposed to reply, submit your responses within 1 hour or within 1 day or within whatever it may be. It depends on that.
Okay, sir. Okay. Thank you.
Okay.
Yes. Any other participant wants to ask any question? Yes, any other participant want to ask the query or any doubt related to SSS?
Madam, please take a question from chat box. I think Kavita madam had asked one question.
It has been replied by sir. Professor Prakash Bansuri is asking that, will you please highlight on documentation process or supporting documents?
Okay, both the things are covered by both the previous speakers. But as far as PSS is concerned, the documentation process, supporting documents, nothing. Only you have to make the. I have shown you how to analyze it. Okay, you have to make the analysis. You have to collect every. Okay, that's why, and keep the all the forms and their analysis made by the committee, IQC committee or the committee formed by the principal, and also share that feedbacks, common feedbacks, and whatever the metrics you receive, you get their calculations with your students, and the students put it on the website. If you visit my website, college website, you will see our analysis and this graph on our website, you will find it. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir. Any other question? I think participants have cleared their doubts.
Okay.
One of the question is again, sir. What are the practical problems?
Okay, last question. Last question is there. I will take it. Last question.
Yes, sir.
Can you highlight on what are the practical problems many colleges faced during this process? This is a new process. Okay. The probable problems I have highlighted already.
Yes.
That is, most of the parents are not ready to provide their numbers of their wards, particularly girl students. They are feeling awkward to share their numbers, their email IDs. This is the problem. Then most of don't know how to type. Okay, that is a problem. If they opened that link and they can't write properly in English there, okay, you can't type properly in Hindi, then some impractical demands. For example, when I was steering the NACPIER team, second cycle as a NAC coordinator, while with interaction with the students, one student raised a question and demanded the ladies NCC should be started, and NAC took that suggestion and mentioned it in the report. You know, very impractical, as there was no provision to start the ladies NCC. We sent our application, but we can't do it because it is central government policy. It's such impractical questions should not be there. These are the technical problems therein. The students' awareness, but most of the 99% students have never give negative feedbacks. Some accent students they are everywhere, and we should have to do not take seriously regarding such any particular person. But most of the students talks nicely about their situations. Please. Thank you, ma'am.
Okay. Thank you so much, sir, for your valuable guidance and time.
Namaskar. Okay, thank you. I'm leaving. Okay. May I leave? May I leave or stay here?
Yes. Sir, now we are moving towards the next session. That is for the feedback link is shared. All participants are requested to please fill the feedback link and attendance link so that we can get your valuable feedbacks for this event, so that we can encourage for the next sessions to be organized for you people. So all the participants are requested to please fill the feedback, the link given in the chat box, and share in the WhatsApp group also. Now, I request Professor U.M. Rawat, sir, IQAC coordinator and head of mechanical engineering department, to please propose vote of thanks on this event. Please, sir.
Thank you, madam. Myself, Uma Shankar Rawat, IQAC coordinator and head of mechanical engineering department. I'm here to propose the vote of thanks for the today's online seminar on NAC accreditation and assessment process. First of all, I thank Professor Dr. Leena Gahane, madam, Deputy Advisor NAC Bengaluru, for accepting our invitation. And sparing her valuable time. I thank Principal Professor Captain Dr. Nitin Sonje, sir, Principal Government Polytechnic, Miraj, for guiding us. I also thank Professor Dr. A.M. Nawle, sir, Head Department of English, Shivaji Mahavidyalaya, Udgir, for guiding us on SSS, that is Student Satisfaction Survey. I thank our management chairman, Professor Dr. G.K. Deshmukh, sir, and Secretary Sri Amol Nana Chavan, sir, for providing the for encouraging us and providing the necessary resources for this webinar. I thank Principal Professor Dr. S.V. Deshpande, sir, Vice Principal Professor Dr. U.S. Mugle, sir, for their continuous support for organizing such webinars. I thank NAC coordinator Professor A. Patil sir, all the head of the departments, faculties, all the principals of various colleges, faculties, non-teaching staff for participating in this webinar. I once again thank all for making this national webinar successful. Thank you. Hand over to Professor Kulkarni ma'am.
Thank you. I wish all the best.